In this video, we're going to cover conflict theory and feminist theory. Conflict theory is another macro sociological theory. And as mentioned in the last video, it emerged as sort of an opposition to functionalism. The main figure in conflict theory is Karl Marx, who you also want to know for the exam. Karl Marx proposed that society is divided into two classes. The bourgeois that own the means of production, so this would be the factory owners, and the proletariat that do not own the means of production and are exploited by the bourgeois. And this was very big at the time of the industrial era. So Karl Marx essentially had this idea that the proletariat will eventually revolt against the bourgeois to eliminate the oppression. And this was seen as revolutions. And at the time, there were a number of revolutions going on, so there was considerable support for Karl Marx's theories. Now, conflict theory doesn't have to apply only to the bourgeois and the proletariat. It can be generalized to the idea that individuals and societies compete over limited resources. This competition eventually is going to be resolved by social changes that reduce inequality. And these social changes can also be abrupt. That's also another difference with functionalism, that the changes are slow. So here, you can have changes that are very significant and very swift. Now, conflict theory, of course, also has cons. The main con is that it fails to explain the stability of societies. So as we know, societies are not in constant conflict. So when we look at societies, they are constantly changing, but most of the changes are quite minor. Okay, so I also wanted to talk about feminist theory. Feminist theory is a specific application of conflict theory, so it's also a macro sociological theory. Instead of focusing on class inequality, feminist theory is focusing on gender inequality. So there are a lot of studies in feminist theory looking at how men are oppressing women. So a common example is income inequality, how men and women can be completing the same jobs, the same tasks, and be equally competent, but men are still paid more than women in many instances.